Hey everyone, and welcome to Scuba Travel and Adventure. My name is Thomas. The second part of the video I promised while we were diving the wreck C-53. The C-53 was originally built in Tampa in 1943 at the Wilson Marine Shipworks as a minesweeper for service during World War II, at which time she was named the USS Scafo. Immediately upon completion, she went into the battle in the Pacific Theater, measuring 184 feet long, 33 feet wide, and 40 feet high from keel to the top of the superstructure. She participated in a pre-invasion mineswipes at Langian Gulf on January 6, 1945, and Zambales at Subic Bay on January 29th and 31st. After completing the pre-invasion mineswipes, she helped extended and cleared areas during and after the initial troop landings and provided anti-submarine and anti-aircraft protection for transports. The Scafo was later awarded as a Presidential Unit Citation and 5 battle stars for her service at the sea. At the conclusion of the war in 1946, she was decommissioned. In 1962, the C-53 was sold to the Mexican Navy, where she was converted to an Admiral-class gun mode and renamed and numbered as the Felipe Xiantunkat C-53, named after Felipe Santiago Xiantunkat, who was the general in the Mexican Army under President Antonio López de Santa Anna. From 37 years, from 1962 to 1999, she patrolled the Gulf of Mexico and the Mexican Caribbean Sea, servicing in rescue missions and patrolling the region for illegal arms and drugs. After 55 years of service, she was permanently decommissioned. Sinking the C-53 as an artificial reef and dive attraction was designed and carried on by ANOT, Cozumel Watersports and Tourism Association, in collaboration with local dive shops and the Prague Marino artifice, the Cozumel. The inspiration came from another place where ships had been successfully sunk by and for divers, Canada. According to Ecodivers Cozumel, this project started in 1998 at the DEMA show. They met some Canadian folks that were making artificial reefs for their diving areas by getting old boats from their government, cleaning and preparing them for sinking and diving safely. And they gave them inspiration. Once back in Mexico, they started knocking doors to get an old out-of-commission Navy boat. During this time, the National Marine Park artifice, the Cozumel, was starting, so in coordination with them as a federal marine authority, they started inviting all different groups of community, the local authorities, and of course the ANOT members, which is the local dive shop association. After more than a year, the President Ernesto Zedillo authorized 3 boats for such a project, which now are in Veracruz, Cancun, and Cozumel. Finally, on June 5th, 2000, the C-53 was sent to the bottom of the ocean to her final resting place in about 80 feet of water, landing upright on a soft landing on a sandbar. Sitting perfectly upright, she became an attraction to thousands of scuba divers and provides a new home to sea life. The C-53 has become a major attraction for divers who travel here from all over the world to experience a sunken ship with a fascinating history of saving lives for 2 different countries. The C-53 is an easily accessible dive site, and many local dive operators take divers out on a daily basis. While it is located just off Chankanap Park, it is not a shore dive due to unpredictable currents that run through the area. For our dive here, we chose an afternoon dive with Dive Paradise. After a short boat ride and through dive briefing, we were ready to descend to the wreck. With the boat secured to the buoy, we entered the crystal clear water and immediately saw the wreck below. As our group of divers followed our dive master down the line, and just as briefed, we had a fairly significant current running. Descending on the wreck is quite dramatic, and we were able to see almost the entire topside of the wreck immediately upon entering the water. Most of divers didn't have a problem swimming down while using the line to guide them. But it is definitely something anyone who dives here should be comfortable with. As predicted, the current subsided at depth to a comfortable, gentle movement of water that was easy to swim with or against. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to my channel, like, comment below. Hit the notification bell to get updated on my future adventures.